Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'd. Ahabati fillah, from one of the major sins that we have to do our utmost to avoid, and is a very common sin which is widespread in our community, is a woman's denying her husband his right. And that doesn't mean that the husbands don't deny their wives of many rights, but this is a very important right that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam emphasized. And we know the mufasid, and we know the mufasid, we know the sinfulness, and we know the wickedness, and we know the harm that results from a woman denying herself to her husband, because that means that now they have, the man has done what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pleases from him, and done it in the halal fashion, and gotten married, and paid his dowry, and done all the things to try to make a harmonious relationship, and then his wife denies him those pleasures, which is his right over her, which is her duty to him. And this is very important that this does not happen, because as mentioned, many sins result, or are a result of this. So many sins, the sins multiply from this. For example, if the woman is denying her husband that which is lawful for him, and he's trying to take the lawful path, it may tempt him to find a mistress. It may tempt him to fornicate. It may tempt him to go to pornography. It may tempt him to masturbation and all of these other types of activities which are muharram. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, if a man calls his wife to bed and she refuses, and he goes to sleep angry with her, the angels will curse her until morning. And this is a hadith in Bukhari. Ruahu Bukhari. This is a hadith in Sahih Bukhari. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, if a man calls his wife to bed and then she refuses. And we're not, this, it doesn't matter if she's in a bad mood. It doesn't matter if she says, I'm busy now. It doesn't matter. No, this is an important right that he needs. Many of the men, and especially in their youth, they need this even more so. They need the comfort of their wife. And then to be denied that, this can cause all kind of wickedness, and wickedness to spread in the land, just because of a bad attitude, just because someone not being in the mood. In another hadith, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, and this is a hadith in Al-Bazzar, and it's in Sahih al-Jami'. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, if a woman calls his wife to bed, let her respond, even if she is riding on the back of a camel, meaning even if she is busy. This is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. This is the advice, and this is the order of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that the women should not deny their husbands this very important right, and that the wickedness that results of that, the harms that are a result of that denial, only tend to multiply, only tend to bring more and more harm and facade in the community. And then the women wonder why, oh, my husband wants another wife, or my husband wants a divorce, or my husband has an illicit affair, oh, my husband is on Facebook, oh, my husband, he's on social media looking for this, oh, my husband is watching this, oh, my husband is doing this. Naam, he is to blame for all of those things which are wicked. He is to blame, but perhaps you can be a means to him going to that wickedness. So don't be a means to shar, be a means to khair, be a means to khair. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.